The hottest holiday ticket in Metro Vancouver went on sale today, and the overwhelming demand to see Bright Nights in Stanley Park overloaded the website of the company the park board contracted to handle the release. 100,000 people visited that site this afternoon. As CTV's Shannon Patterson reports, it led to hours-long waits for people hoping to snag the coveted tickets.
With 3 weeks to go till opening night, firefighters and park board staff are busy stringing up the 3 million lights that will illuminate Stanley Park during the immensely popular Bright Nights holiday event.
3 million lights is a lot of work, but a bunch of us too just got off our 24-hour shift, so now we're continuing on to volunteer. It is a lot of fun. It is a great time, and also, like, especially when you see it at night, it just glows. It's beautiful.
There's some people that come here and say, you know, we've been coming here for 20 years, you know, and I just wouldn't miss it. And it is. It becomes the thing to do, right?
With the Christmas train now back to full capacity after years of COVID shutdowns and repairs, 68,000 tickets for Bright Nights were up for grabs starting at noon today. Showpass, the company contracted to handle the sale, funneled potential buyers into a painfully slow-moving virtual queue that paused several times, leading to hours-long waits to access the website.
We do try to hand it off to people who focus solely on ticketing, that's not our bread and butter. And so they do handle all of our special events and other things like festival lights. So they're well versed in this. And so I think it is a function of the high demand.
Once in the portal, there's no indication of how many tickets are available to purchase in each time slot, leading to a maddening game of click and hope.
So we understand that it can be a challenge for customers. But I think patience is what's rewarded here. And so we know not everyone has a great experience or it's a lengthy experience, but it's the best we can do with what we have right now.
When Bright Nights gets underway on November 29th, the park board is hoping the event runs smoothly after extreme weather and power outages led to cancellations during the Halloween ghost train.
We're as confident as we can be. You know, we've done a lot of work to get things back on, you know, back on track, pardon the train pun there.
Bright Nights isn't just a beloved holiday tradition, it's a fundraiser for the Professional Firefighters Burn Fund.
In past years, we've done really well. Like before COVID, I think we brought in about 200,000. This year, we're hoping to get close to that.
The demand is clearly there, but the ticketing process isn't putting Bright Nights buyers in the holiday spirit. Shannon Patterson, CTV News, Vancouver.